Good morning, one and all. This was my free paper topic last year, which won the best paper in the glaucoma session. The topic was deciphering the conundrum of aerosolization during non-contact tonometry. Right, so this was during the COVID pandemic that we did this study where the cases of COVID were rising worldwide. We all knew that COVID spreads through aerosols, and there were a lot of published papers on the same that aerosolization could cause the spread of COVID. Non-contact tonometry is a procedure that is used daily in our OPD for screening IOP. And there was a published article from the 1991 journal where it was published that during NCT there was generation of micro aerosols, and this caused, based on which many ophthalmic bodies issued guidelines to avoid NCT during the same. So our study was to check whether aerosols were actually produced during non-contact tonometry. So what we did is we collaborated with the fluid velocimetry team from IISc Bangalore, and we performed our studies there. We used frontal lighting and a shadowgraphy setup to set up our experiment. And what shadowgraphy exactly is a combination, in combination with a high resolution camera, even particles as small as 10 to 30 microns could be photographed. We used a fluorescein setup where a fluorescein dye was instilled into the patient's eye, and we used a blue LED light excitation to capture images. NCT was performed in normal eye conditions after one drop of a lubricant and after installation of two drops of lubricants. Our results were that in normal eye conditions, there was no aerosols generation whatsoever when NCT was performed. And this was also refurbished by on DSLR imaging in the nightscape mode to see fluorescein. After installation of one drop of a lubricant, if you see here, there is minimal aerosolization occurring as seen by the droplets. After instilling of two drops of the lubricant, what we saw was that there was copious amount of aerosolization which even went back up to the port of the NCT. Again, in fluorescein study also we saw similar results. You can see the splatter which came out there after this thing, and you can see the splatter which has gone back onto the NCT machine also. We use mathematical modeling to find the distance to which these droplets can flow in an, especially in an air-conditioned room or in a low airflow. Our conclusion, hence, for the study was that no aerosols are produced in normal eye conditions, so it could be safely performed in the OPD. Mild splatter of aerosols were observed on one installation of a drop of lubricant, so NCT should not be performed in watery eyes and immediately post-op. Profuse splatter is noted on two drops of installation, so NCT shouldn't be performed post-drop installation at all. And contamination of the NCT may occur in case of profuse aerosolization. Our study added was the first to use shadowgraphy and high-speed photography to demonstrate aerosol generation. It was the first study to demonstrate that no visible or invisible aerosols are generated during NCT in a normal eye condition, and it affirms that NCT could be performed and should be only avoided in condition with watery eyes. Thank you.